Now, First Alert Weather with meteorologist Tyler Jankowski.
I'd say those emails that you get in your inbox are a lot. I feel like I get hundreds a day of just all that spam from
you do.
Everywhere.
I've been thinking here, what does a news anchor ask for Christmas?
Ask for Christmas? You can't go wrong with a new tie. You always need more ties.
And you need a knot with a dimple.
See, actually, you just are you going to compliment me on
it's
air
a
for
very,
mine?
It's a very
thank
nice,
you.
Very
I appreciate
nice
that.
Yes.
So is this forecast that you got coming our way.
It is. I guess if you don't have snow on the ground, maybe it's not the best because we're not getting any tonight. But at least on the roads, we're not talking about snow or ice.
Yeah.
Or anything like that this evening. This is the time lapse, the haze cam time lapse. This is the one looking off to the south and west. A lot of blue sky there at about 12:30 this afternoon. And then we had some filtered sun. And I think for tomorrow, this that you see here is kind of what the sky will look like. We're not talking about low clouds, but there will certainly be enough in the sky to make it kind of cloudy looking. Look at the sunset though. That's the one nice thing about the thin high clouds. Nice pink view there. And then look at that, just around 5 o'clock. So anyways, going forward, quiet. This is the view at the State House. It's 26. And all of the weather sensors, they only can see up to about 10,000 feet. So that's why it says it's clear, but we know some of those high clouds are out there, just a sign that it will stay dry overnight. You're not going to get anything from clouds that high up. And it stays quiet through tomorrow. The next two things we're watching are really icy mixes. There's one on Friday, not very much with it. And then there's another one on Monday. So kind of shaky weather going into the rest of the what's left of this year into the first part of 2020. So Storm Tracker shows the clouds there, the high clouds, but there's no rain or snow or storms across the Northeast. Temperatures in the 20s pretty much across the board, 32 we have in Springfield. So again, tomorrow I don't think it's a very bright day, but the clouds will be on the thinner, higher side, so you'll sense that the sun is behind them. And then on Thursday, sun to the north and clouds to the south. It turns a little cooler on Thursday, but nothing too cold. And then on Friday, especially Friday morning, this is 5 a.m., see this pink color, eastern Vermont and also in the Adirondacks. So it's not snow, but it may be just a little icing. A little, but if it's ice, it doesn't take much for icy travel. And then that leaves, so it's cloudy for the rest of Friday. So not a lot. It's not like a rain that's going to wash the snow off the slopes, but this is where the icy travel will be. Newport, St. Jay, Saranac Lake, at least a possibility at this point for Friday morning. So tomorrow morning, we'll start out in the teens for most of us on Christmas morning. And then basically between 30 and 40 tomorrow. So it's not very cold. Certainly above average for Christmas Day. Thursday there with more sun, so it's a brighter Thursday, especially north. We'll watch for some of that ice Friday morning, but it's not a lot of liquid falling from the clouds on Friday, mainly just in the morning. And then the weekend is dry for the most part. If there is something that happens, it would be late on Sunday, a mix. But most of that is on Monday when it's pretty steady, I think, for much of Monday. But we'll keep an eye on it. Turns cooler for New Year's Eve with some snow showers. Tom?
Tyler.